My name is Dr. Peter Nigrovic at the Brigham and Women's Hospital, Boston Children's Hospital, and Harvard Medical School. I thank you for your interest in our paper, Megakaryocytes Compensate for Kit Insufficiency in Murine Arthritis. Our study reached two central conclusions, which turn out to be surprisingly interrelated. First, the role of mast cells as a contributor to inflammation is not all or none, but varies with marrow and stromal context. Second, megakaryocytes, MKs for short, can serve as inflammatory cells in their own right, even aside from their platelets. Let me then lead you briefly through our results to show you how we reached these conclusions using a murine model of inflammatory arthritis. Mast cells are immune sentinels distributed throughout the body, including in the lining of the joints. Mast cell development is highly dependent on KIT, the receptor for stem cell factor. Mice with defects affecting KIT often lack mast cells. Mast cell deficiency can also be engineered in other ways. Interestingly, sometimes different mast cell deficient mice respond differently to animal models of disease. These discrepancies have led to considerable controversy within the mast cell field. We examined discordant experimental arthritis in two strains of mast cell deficient mice bearing mutations that affect KIT. WWV mice in the WBV6 background are relatively resistant to arthritis mediated by transfer of Kb by N serum. By contrast, SASH mice in the B6 background are susceptible. We used crisscross bone marrow transplantation to define the contribution of marrow and stroma to arthritis susceptibility. Interestingly, WWV and SASH recipients became susceptible to arthritis. This finding shows that arthritis resistance in WWV mice reflects both marrow and stromal compartments. Further, it shows that a lineage from SASH donors, which are genetically unable to make mast cells, can patch the gap left by missing mast cells in WWV. To identify what lineage from SASH restored arthritis, we first considered neutrophils, which are relatively deficient in WWV mice. Our previous studies had shown that IL-1 is a key factor produced by mast cells in arthritis. Neutrophils are also a potential IL-1 source, and we confirmed by transfer of IL-1 sufficient and deficient marrow that IL-1 was an essential contribution of the donor lineage. However, adoptive transfer of neutrophils failed to rescue arthritis. Further, transfer of GFI-1 deficient marrow that is genetically unable to produce neutrophils did fix arthritis. We conclude that neutrophils are not the missing IL-1 donor. Interestingly, WWV mice are also relatively deficient in megakaryocytes because of the role of KIT in MK development, although circulating platelet numbers remain normal because residual MKs are larger. To test the role of platelets and MKs, we engrafted marrow deficient in the lineage-specific determinants NFE2 and GP6, and confirmed that neither could restore arthritis. Thus, the missing marrow cells belong to the platelet megakaryocyte lineage. We expected that platelets would be the culprit, since they can release IL-1 containing microparticles. Surprisingly, however, WWV platelets were normal both in number and in production of IL-1 microparticles. Further, transfer of wild-type platelets failed to restore arthritis. Thus, platelets do not appear to be the missing IL-1 source either. These findings suggested that MKs might themselves be the IL-1 donor. Consistent with this possibility, we found that MKs were a rich source of IL-1, including via circulating IL-1 containing MK microparticles. Correspondingly, engraftment of wild-type megakaryocytes restored arthritis even without substantial platelet production, while MKs cultured from IL-1 deficient mice did not. We conclude that megakaryocytes can serve as a direct donor of IL-1 in arthritis, potentially via pro-inflammatory MK microparticles. We need to highlight two caveats with respect to our data. First, our studies were performed in the murine WWV context. Relevance to more typical wild-type strains and to humans will need to be established. Second, although MK microparticles are an appealing way for MKs to act at a distance, our data do not prove that they play this role in arthritis. MKs release soluble as well as microparticle-associated IL-1. Although engrafted MKs produced 50-fold fewer platelets than achieved by direct platelet transfer, we cannot exclude a role for these platelets in a restoration of arthritis susceptibility. Despite these caveats, our findings have important implications for both mast cell and megakaryocyte fields. First, they illustrate how mast cells act within a complex hematopoietic and non-hematopoietic environment. Strains of mast cell deficient mice with contrasting phenotypes are not problems for the mast cell field, but rather opportunities to develop a more nuanced understanding of when mast cells are necessary and when they are not. Second, while platelets are well recognized as immune actors, our findings now establish that megakaryocytes also possess previously unappreciated direct pro-inflammatory capacity. We believe that megakaryocytes therefore merit dedicated study as immune cells in their own right. On behalf of my co-authors, and in particular of Dr. Pierre Kunin, who spearheaded these studies, I thank you for your attention.